I think many people are hopeful that AI can be transformative, and it can be transformative in helping doctors and nurses see around the corner to what's coming next.
AI eyes can watch us. They never get bored. They can, you know, note everything, no detail too small for them to be interested in.
I think we understand that information now is being collected about us when we're sitting in front of our computers and we're surfing from site to site. But increasingly, because we're putting internet connections into the products that we're putting into our homes, we're allowing that information collection to kind of come more offline, just into our everyday lives.
I think that, you know, going back to, you know, like the things that you all are doing around like ethics and fairness and like human dignity, you know, if we kept that like at the core operating system of like all the things that we're doing, we will think about, okay, what does this mean? What's the experience for others, you know?
Have you considered all of the potential risks to different other parties? Have you considered this product through an ethical lens?
The goal is no longer just to create a 3D character of a person, but it's to even build a fully autonomous person. One that has the ability to, where you can actually interact with, you can have a conversation with.
And so I think we need to have that larger question of trust and when and how we use these technologies at all, but also, and who's at the table at all steps.